Welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning. I'm the master taster of Whisky.com. And today we have an old relative here, our cask. It's a Glen Garioch. It's written Glen Garioch, but it's pronounced in the old Doric Aberdeenshire dialect as Garioch. And the name comes from a small river, the Garioch. Glen Garioch, 12 years of age, with a decent amount of sherry cask influence, unchill filtered, uncolored, 48% ABV, 12 years of age, close to 40 euros, dollars, pounds, wherever you live. So this is a bottle which shows everything as it should be. The question is the taste as it looks like from the outside? Well, I had that bottle already in the year 2012, but unfortunately I did not take a video in English language. And the distillery is one of the oldest in Scotland. It was founded in 1797. So it's an 18th century distillery. And to show this age, they have on the card box, on the back, they have old pictures. But if you look carefully at the pictures, they are from 1892, so close to 100 years after the foundation of the distillery. They took those ancient pictures, so more than 220 years in operation. No, that's not quite right, because there had been a time of mothballing after the big British recession. And I think I was there in 1995. And the distillery was working, but was close to being mothballed. And then it was reopened several years later. And the first time I had the new bottling style of Glen Garioch had been in, I think, 2009, the Founders Reserve, which came in this bulky bottle. And the time before, they had the old liquor bottle, standard liquor bottle. And those whiskies had a quite different taste, to say at least. So today, or with the Founders Reserve, the taste grew or matured more friendly to our tasting buds. And yeah, I had that whiskey, as I said, in 2012, and it showed, well, some sherry cask influence, a little bit of smokiness, friendliness, fruitiness, and well, after 8 years, it's time to look again into that bottle, if it has changed, and most likely it will have changed, because you can't have your taste that constant over the years, especially for single malt whiskies. If you have a blend, you might be able to work out the drifts in several distilleries by adding more or less of that whiskey. But here we have a single malt whiskey, handcrafted since 1797. This non-chill filtered 12 years old single malt gains its distinctive Highland character. It's in the east, located in the East Highlands and in the city of Old Meldrum. It's not far away from Aberdeen, the capital in that region. A classic marriage of bourbon and sherry casks, fresh heather, poached pears, and just a hint of oak. And tasting notes, fresh heather, rich poached pears, and the sweetest of malted barley. Crème brûlée, sweet ripe fruits, and just a hint of oak give this Glen Garioch a long and memorable finish. That sounds very good. So how to open that? Here is the opener. And they, everywhere they are doing advertisements with this age. So there's the 1797 on the wooden stopper, the cork, and there's the 1797 printed on the cork itself. Fruity, sherry, aromatic. It's already wonderful at the cork. So, here we go. I have to keep a certain distance from the white background, because then the whiskey starts to glow with the light. And this is natural color. There's a hint of smoke in it. Even Glen Garioch, I think, does not use peated barley. But there's a hint of it. And yes, this heather is there. And some ripe fruits, whatever that is. And definitely a sherry note on top of that. Yeah, it's a very friendly, straightforward sipping note on this whiskey. Wonderful. Yeah, cheers. Mm-hmm. The 48% gives an impact. Then there's some orange tangerine fruitiness in it. I looked up the old video and there said it was a mango in it, but not quite in this one. The creme brulee isn't there. I can't find it, but there's a definite note of oak wood in it, even stronger than I noticed it in the old video. Long aftertaste, very oaky aftertaste, strong. So I think that's European sherry casks with a stronger oakiness of the tannins. Yeah, massive. Mm-hmm. The second sip is more gentle on the tongue, because the first one hits quite strongly, but this one is, the second one is more comfortable in your mouth because you're used to this impact. It's 48%, that's not too few. So if you would like to add a little water, I think it will react positively to a little bit of water. There are some other Glen Garioch on the market, the Founders Reserve, even a little bit cheaper than this one, without an age statement, and then a 15-year-old, and those Founders Reserve 12-year-old and the 15-year-old, I think those are the standard range, and then there are some 17, 18-year-old vintage, no, not a vintage, a virgin oak, some vintages. So they are broadening their spectrum in the moment quite a lot. So thank you for watching. Stay tuned. There's more to come.